everyone. Welcome to the Success Coach.
On today's episode, we are on Season 1, Episode 16, on coding with Ashadiee. Today, on today's episode, we'll be coding with Lauren and learning new code. By the way, sorry that I haven't made a lot of progress during these days. It's because COVID has been here a lot lately, so yeah. So let's go ahead and get started. So in today's episode, we will be helping Lauren collect a lot of treasure. Yeah, inshallah, we'll do that. So, let's get started. Today we will help Lauren collect all the treasure, which means this little purple gem and this other one. The goal is try to get at least two. I mean, try to get two because there's no other one. So, what should she do first? Should she move forward? She should move forward. And she will turn right. By the way, remember, she can't just walk on the treasure. She needs to collect it. Like if you're on a mining trip and then when you get treasure, do you just walk on it? No, you collect it. You stand next to it and then you collect it. You don't just immediately just stand on it then you just collected it. You move forward, you collect it, then you turn right. And then you will move forward, and then you will turn left, and then you will move forward. So we will have to do this a lot of times. I mean, two times. We can't duplicate all this. Then it would be 14 blocks. And it says only 8 blocks. What should we do? Well, the hint is right in the toolbox. It's the repeat block. You can use it to repeat a little bit of code multiple times. We're gonna repeat this two times. Okay, not right. Left. Okay, she needs to collect it at the end. If you want, you guys can also come along with me. Like, you can go to code.org and you can do the same thing as me. I'm in lesson 3. By the way, if you haven't watched the first video of this series, the link will be on the description below. She walks and then she gets She lost. Okay. Oh no. We collected too much blocks. So we're going to put that one there. Okay. Let's repeat this again. She will move forward. She will collect it. She will turn right. Move forward. She will turn. Wait. Move forward, collect, turn left, move forward, turn right, collect. I have an idea. What if we put collect at the beginning? And we can move them, we can put a move forward here. Collect it. All right, she's gonna, let's use the step block. Move forward. We're gonna use the step once we're done. Turn left, move forward, collect. Turn left, move forward. Turn right, forward, and then collect. We did it! Oh, I guess we didn't need a repeat block after all. All time total, 9,218 lines of code. Wow. So, even the top universities teach block-based coding, which is Berkeley, Harvard University, I know that. But under the hood, the blocks you have assembled can be also shown in JavaScript, the world's most widely used coding language. Move forward, collect, turn left, move forward, turn right, move forward, collect. Interesting. That is cool, isn't it? By the way, at the end of each of them, I realized that there are like these brackets. Like the brackets. Like not the curly brackets, not the brackets, that not the two brackets that when you put them together, it makes a square. It's like the smooth one, like the one that if you put both of them together, it makes a circle. Look at this code carefully. What do you think will happen? What do you think will happen when the program runs? Laurel. Oh, by the way, her name isn't Lauren. It's actually Laurel. I forgot. Laurel will collect 4 pieces of treasure using this code. 4 pieces. She moves forward. She will collect. She will turn left. She will move forward. Then she's collect. Then she will turn right. Then move forward and correct. She will collect 1 piece of treasure, I think. She tries to collect treasure when there's none, and it causes an error. Is this true? Yeah. Okay. You're almost done. Collect as many pieces of treasure as you can to finish the stage. Okay. We'll move forward 3 times. We're gonna repeat this. For 3 times. Wow. Repeat block. I forgot to. I forgot to. What was it called? I forgot to put in the collect block. Okay. There! She does it 2 times. Okay, not 2 times, 3 times. We're gonna put this right there. And then we are going to... And then, I don't think we're going to need another repeat block, I think. And then she's going to turn left, and then she's going to... We're going to get another repeat block. And for 2 times, she's going to move forward and collect. Then we're going to turn left again. And for 2 times, she'll collect. Actually, I regret that again. We're going to turn this, put that right there. She collects now. Not all, actually. And then, not three times, two times. Like we'll try to collect all of them, not as many as we can. Oh. Well, then you'll move forward, collect then turn left and then move forward then collect. Hopefully, yes, we collected all 9 items. You wrote 14 lines of code. We could have wrote less, but okay. Oh, now we're doing the artist. I didn't know that. Okay, so just so that this video doesn't have any copyrights, I am going to mute it, and I am practically going to say everything they're going to say. Okay. You wouldn't even qualify for the race if you don't have people that are proficient in computer sciences because of how much data the cars collect and the necessity to be able to have people who can write programs that figure out how you can continue to build performance. In these puzzles, you'll be an artist that uses a pencil and draw different shapes. So whenever your artist goes, he'll draw a little line behind them to move around the canvas. You'll use the jump block, the move forward block. Here the move forward blocks is move forward by 100 pixels. When we hit run, what happens? The artist moves forward a certain amount, and that amount is 100 pixels. Pixels are basically very tiny squares in the computer screen. The other block we have in this puzzle is to turn right by 90 degrees, and when we drag that out, we make our artist turn a certain amount, so you can play around with him how far you can want the artist to turn. This is a 90 degree turn, and this is a 120 degree turn. Remember, you can change these values by clicking the arrows next to the values, the numbers for pixels and degrees. Enjoy drawing with your artist. Whoa! Wow, let me see that again. Look, guys. Everyone is making, different people are making things. Wow. Whoa, okay. I'm gonna click continue. Clicks continue. By the way, the first one, I did it. So I'm going to reset everything. Practically, I'm not gonna look. I'm just gonna cover it with my hand. And then we're gonna read the instructions. Hi, I am an artist. You can write code to make me draw almost anything. Play with the blocks in the toolbox to see what they do. Okay, so we're gonna move forward by 100 pixels. We're gonna see that. Oh, he moves forward by 100 pixels. We're going to change the color of it. Okay. Turn right. And then move forward by 100 pixels. Maybe we can repeat this 4 times to make a square. Oh yeah, it is. So we made a square and we can click finish. So this is optional. You don't have to draw a square. You can do anything you want because This is not exactly a puzzle. This is just a, like, you know, little warm-up, I guess. Continue. Okay. Creating art with code. Let's make a cage for my pet monster. Okay, a pet monster with wings. Drag blocks onto the screen to have the artist draw over the gray lines in the picture. Each line is 100 pixels long. Move forward 100 pixels. Turn right by 90. No, not right. No, left. Yeah, it's left. Turn right and then forward by 100 degrees. I mean, pixels. Okay, not left. Actually, right. Click the light bulb for a hint. We don't need one. Okay. So it's loading longer than usual. Yeah. We should try reloading the page. Alright, so that is all what we have for today. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, and click the bell to get more videos. Bye! We'll see you on the next episode!